what is the most intense sport is, or what is the most difficult sport is, I would simply say it's as the marathon, because you have to run and keep on running, and for really a great distance and without rest. It's the exact same game that Facebook and Tencent has to run today, and then, but they are in their lifelong marathon. So with that, good morning ladies and gentlemen. We are the consultants from the University of Colombo. So I'm Madhusha, and I'll be doing the introduction part. Sarala will be analyzing the key issues. Isuri and Subekha will be talking about the alternatives and the recommendations. And finally, the conclusion will be done by myself. Moving on, so Facebook, so it's a top social media platform. And then again, it has so many, it runs basically on the user-related content. So it has Facebook, it has Messenger, it has WhatsApp, and so many other apps. And then when it comes to Tencent, it's the Asia's largest internet company. So it has these messaging apps, and then it has games, and it has chatbots, and it has so many e-commerce platforms. However, both the companies operate in an industry where it does not respect tradition, they respect innovation. So although both the companies are very successful, they face challenges on a day-to-day basis. Therefore, they have to make a move forward and they have to keep on running. So today's question will be all about how Facebook and Tencent win the business model game. So for that, let me call Sarala to analyze the key issues.
Thank you, Madhusha. With that, let's take a step back and consider the strategic analysis which drives our recommendations. Accordingly, here we'll compare Facebook with Tencent. When it comes to Facebook, their vision is to connect every person on the planet. Accordingly, they are mainly a social media networking company. In that case, they have a lot of social media applications such as Facebook, Messenger, Instagram, etc. But when it comes to Tencent, they are into a lot of areas. They are diversified. They are into internet, mobile, and communication services. And when it comes to their social networking applications such as WeChat, it is not only a mobile app, it is a mobile platform. And it has a lot of features, a lot of advanced features that the customers not even expect. And when it comes to gaming, it is the largest digital gaming company in the world. And when it comes to e-commerce, they are also into e-commerce as well. When comparing the markets of the two companies, Facebook is into all the countries except China, Iran, and North Korea. But Tencent is mainly dominated in China, and they are in the process of expanding into West. When it comes to the revenue streams of the two companies, Facebook mainly depends on advertising. 97% of revenue is from advertising, and only 3% is from gaming. But when it comes to Tencent, they have a lot of revenue sources. They are into gaming, advertising, and they collect revenue through their membership and through their e-commerce services as well. And when it comes to the strengths of the two companies, Facebook has a very large user base, and they have a lot of active users, and they are loyal as well. When it comes to Tencent, their strength is their innovation. They innovate a lot. They have been able to accelerate their innovation and thereby reach the market first to get the first mover advantage. And when it comes to strategy, Facebook's strategy is acquisition. They have acquired WhatsApp, Instagram, Masquerade, etc. But when it comes to Tencent, they acquire as well as they form alliances. They grab the talent. Through acquisition, they expand. Whereas Facebook, they expand, they grow profits, as well as they acquire talent through acquisition. Moving on, let's identify the challenges that these two companies face. The biggest challenge they face is the security threat. When it comes to Facebook, their gaming apps are highly considered as insecure. The Family is an example for it. And when it comes to Tencent, their WeChat payment system is considered as a security threat by the Indian government. So both these companies are facing security threats. And secondly, it is the competition. These two companies are competitors, but then again, both these companies face competition through other tech giants such as Microsoft, Alibaba, etc. Thirdly, expansion is itself as an issue, is an issue. When it comes to Facebook, they could not go beyond, they could not cross the Chinese firewall. They could not, mainly because of government's concern on privacy issues and on blocking sensitive data. So if they are to expand into China, they have to form contacts, they have to have proper contacts with the government officials. And when it comes to Tencent, they are facing difficulties in expanding into West. Because mainly due to Donald Trump's presidency, Donald Trump has imposed many tariffs, many trade restrictions on China, which has created an unstable situation in China. In US. Therefore, Chinese will be having difficulties when entering China. With all these challenges, we have identified that the key issue that these two companies are facing is how they could win the business model race in order to gain competitive advantage and to remain competitive in their respective markets. With that, I would like to invite Isri to talk about the recommendation.
Thank you, Sarla. So now that we've identified what the key issue is, we will be talking about this in two different sections. So I will take you through as to what Facebook can do in order to win the business model game. And later on, my teammate Subekha will take on Tencent. So if we talk about Facebook, our recommendation mainly revolves around a product portfolio management. So if you take the different products that Facebook offers to their consumers, you can see it's a variety of things. But when you categorize it, you can see that there are problem children, a dog, stars, and one cash cow mainly. So what we tend to do in our recommendation is to implement certain changes. So if we take the problem children, that is e-commerce platform, there is a growing trend that people are moving into e-commerce. However, although Facebook do have an e-commerce platform and also e-payments, they are not as popular as the other ones. So what we want to do through our recommendation is to make a few changes so that this e-commerce platform can be turned into a star. And also, when it comes to gaming, there are a few glitches and few issues with Facebook. So those changes will again be made in order to convert it into a star. And we will also focus on WhatsApp. WhatsApp has a very wide user base that when compared to other messaging services. However, it doesn't generate any revenue. So therefore, what we want to do is by implementing certain changes to convert WhatsApp into a cash cow. And the other one is we'll be focusing on Facebook. They are the main revenue generator for Facebook. So like through advertisements, they generate a lot of revenue. However, there are certain areas in which Facebook could improve. So now, let me take you through the detailed version of our recommendation. Okay, so the strategy is called manage the mix. So under this, we will be focusing on these four products, and I will take you through the different activities that can be done in order to improve them. So when it comes to the e-commerce platform, like I said, they are not as popular as the other e-commerce platforms. So what they can do is, Facebook has a very good relationship with PayPal because they use these PayPal services in chatbox and they sell products through that. So they have a very good relationship, and they will be able to leverage this relationship in their e-commerce platform to convey the message to the consumers that it's secure to buy products through their platform. And also, after they do that, another thing that the company can do is, this is the same strategy that Tencent used as well, they can acquire e-commerce startups and provide them the reach that these companies will not have. So basically, it would be like an alliance or rather acquisition of e-commerce startups in order to boost their e-commerce platform. Then the next one is games. One of the main issues that the games provided by Facebook has is the privacy issues. And also there are certain things like you have to send friend requests, and this annoys people a lot. So those areas can be addressed. And also, when you compare the games that Facebook provides and Tencent provides, Facebook has very mellow like Farmville and Candy Crush and all of that. However, the trend we see today is that people are into more intense games. So the company can look into the possibility of developing new games which are more in line with this trend. So that is the second one that they can do in terms of games. And also WhatsApp. Like I said, WhatsApp is it's very popular among the users. However, it doesn't generate any money. And the company has spent billions in acquiring it, and they haven't been able to get back that money. So what we suggest the company can do is to have advertising, but they have to make sure that it does not disrupt the consumers, and they have to come up with a way in order to have user-friendly advertising, maybe a small strip like advertising banners, so that they would be able to generate revenue through that as well. And then in Facebook, what they can do to improve is to add more interactive features so that the eyeball time of the consumers increase, and thereby the demand they would get for their Facebook would increase and the revenue will increase. And here we say the company has taken one step forward towards developing augmented reality. So if the company can fast forward this process, they would be able to achieve this objective. So that is on how we can implement the strategy. Well, this is the timeline that we have come up with. So this is a very short timeline. We think that within the first quarter, because Facebook and WhatsApp changes are not that major, so these upgrades can be done within the first quarter. And then developing games could take up to about 3 quarters, and the e-commerce platform, because it involves a lot of relationship building and, you know, searching companies, it would take about 1 year. And the resources that the company would need in order to implement this strategy would be HR, the human resource, mainly the technical experts, programmers, and also cybersecurity experts in order to overcome the issues in their games. And also they would require funds. However, like any strategy, there are certain risks involved in our strategy manage the mix. So we identified 2 main risks. The first one is the consumers might resist to do the upgrades because, of course, we don't like advertising. So the mitigation strategy that the company can use, like I said earlier, is to make them user-friendly. And then the next one is competition. There's a lot of competition from different companies, so in order to avoid that, the company can do continuous innovation. So the strategy that we've given is more immediate, which happens in like 1 year. But after these wishes are made and improvements are made in their existing products, of course the company can think of innovating and coming up with new products in order to improve more. So with that, I invite Subekha. Thank you.
Thank you, Isumi. Now let me take you all through the Tencent ways in which Tencent can win this business model race. We have given you 2 options for Tencent where they can expand in other countries and they can ensure strong presence. Currently speaking, they are into Thailand, India and other parts of Asian market. However, their main focus is on China. This has made Tencent to lack global presence. Therefore, we recommend Tencent to have strong presence in Asian region so that they can think of going global. The second alternative that we recommend is to engage in diversification. This is where Tencent can engage into related diversification, where they can go into technological side and develop and coming up with new innovation. However, considering the pros and cons of this alternative, the first alternative would eliminate the over-reliance in China. Because currently Tencent is over-relied on China. What if the Chinese consumers' trend changes? Tencent need to have another revenue stream. Tencent need to have a support for that. Also, when it comes to the negative side, it is more risky. However, when we compare this alternative with the second alternative that we have come up, we prefer this alternative would be more beneficial for Tencent to have a strong global presence. Because when they have to diversify, that is going to be more risky and more complicated for Tencent's management. However, when we diversify, we can get more revenue streams. However, that cannot be met with the risk and the complexity that Tencent is going to face through diversification. Therefore, we have selected the first option, that is where Tencent can expand in other countries, especially in Southeast Asia, and ensure their strong presence. Moving on to the implementation of Tencent new strategy, that is go global, we have come up with four key activities. For Tencent to go global, first they have to eliminate the defects that they are facing right now, maybe the mistakes. One of the most important mistakes that Tencent faces is the security threat. Indian and Thailand government has exclusively stated that Tencent payment scheme system is not supportive and secure. Therefore, before getting into this implementation, Tencent first level up their current operations by ensuring more safety and user-friendly as well. For that, they need to have a cybersecurity team. Through that cybersecurity team, their products can be delivered to customers in a more secured way. Once they level up their current operation, they can think of go global. Here we mainly focuses on expanding their customer base outside China, where they can first have a market research on the nearby areas and identify the lucrative market. From that, they can form alliances. Currently, Tencent is forming alliances with the local markets in China. So having expertise on alliances, Tencent can go and form local alliances with other regions in Asian market, especially maybe Macau or other regions. Then they can offer the same product with few customization. Yes, even we've targeted the Asian market, customer preferences and taste do differ. Therefore, our product should be delivered to customers in a way that they match with customer requirements. And also, once we deliver the product with few customizations, such as maybe we can adjust the languages, we can bring more customized features into our product, through that, we believe Tencent can reach their global presence, especially in the Asian market. And we believe this go global strategy, as a short term, is going to be carried out in the next 2 years. Once they have the strong presence, once they get the strong presence in the Asian market, they can think of going global, maybe the Western side and the European side. However, for this, we will be requiring market analysts and also programmers, and also we shall require financial strength. In order to talk about the risk that we will be facing by this go global strategy, first risk would be uncertainty involved in getting government support. When we go to other regions, it is obvious that we will not be exactly getting government support. For that, we should have better relationship with other governments, maybe via lobbying. And the other risk that we will be facing is the possibility of mismatching customer taste. For that, we should have a proper upgrading and identify custom taste in a manner so that we will be eliminating that risk as well. In order to talk about the implications, I would like to welcome Madhusha.
Thank you, Subhika. Now let's focus on the implications of our manage the mix strategy. So basically, it would increase the customer base. And because we are done with our defects, so it would definitely increase our customer base. And second is this, there would be large initial outlays because we have to develop new games, we have to make partnerships and all. And then for Facebook, it will generate a new revenue stream in terms of commission from the e-commerce platforms. And then, focusing on the implications of Go Global strategy, Tencent would have more global customers, as currently they are focused. 10% Chinese customers, but now they would, with our strategy, they would have access to more and more global customers. And then although this strategy would also have large initial cash outflows, however, they could increase their revenue. So we forecasted the revenue to be 200 billion RMB by 2018. So in conclusion, I would like to say, so Facebook and Tencent are in a constant race. They have to win their marathon. So we suggested to manage the mix properly for Facebook and go global for Tencent. So both of them will make them to keep moving forward in their marathon. For that, ladies and gentlemen, it's all for today. And the floor is open for questions.
Yeah, I think it's very, thank you first, and it's very well organized, the webinar presentation. I have a few questions. First one is, for Facebook, your main recommendations management mix. Have you thought about China as being the largest population, given this is an eye-catching business? China has the largest population, and it's also fast-growing economy in the world. How does Facebook deal with China?
Currently, it's facing the national security is the thing that is threatening Facebook into entering into China, because Chinese government is so caring about their national security because of the privacy issues and the certain mistakes and the mismatch in Facebook that has caused Facebook not to enter into China. Therefore, Facebook should identify some other strategies in order to capture Chinese customers. And maybe through in a way that is a very genuine way by eliminating privacy issues and security threats as well.
And also, like other companies like Google and other companies have tried to move into China, but most of those companies have failed. So which means that the same thing could happen to Facebook if they try to move into China as well. So we believe that it's important, first of all, for the company to focus on their current products to improve it and, you know, increase their customer base around the world, and then think of moving into China in the future.
Okay, so it's not a near-term option for that, right?
Yes. We believe it's not.
I want to know, maybe you all play in the WeChat, WhatsApp, right?
Yes.
Have you played WeChat?
Yeah.
Then how do you know about Tencent? Where do you get the information from Tencent? Search in the internet.
We can't explain the case, actually.
Oh,
yeah.
So you haven't played WeChat and you haven't go to the website and Tencent, and even you don't have to talk with some Chinese guy.
No. So we relied on the information that was given on the case.
You just rely on the information. Maybe you're a bit wrong. Okay. As I know, if we doing some research or report, maybe we have to know more. We have to exercise something. Maybe we never play WeChat. Maybe we can find someone to play for us and see how it works. And I think it's more efficient.
Great. Well, thank you very much. I really enjoyed that.
Yes.
It was really impressive work. Thank you. I've got a couple of questions about the Facebook and the Tencent proposals, and a sort of general question overall. So on the Facebook one, it seems to me that a large part of your manage the mix strategy is about squeezing more revenue out of WhatsApp and also getting better at e-commerce. To what extent do you think that concerns about privacy could get in the way of that? So what I'm thinking about is, you know, if putting more adverts on WhatsApp which are targeted to particular users exposes the fact that Facebook is using that data, or if people are more concerned about using e-commerce on Facebook because they're concerned about how much of their data that goes to Facebook as well, how can Facebook overcome that?
Secure advertising method, maybe through WhatsApp. advertisements, we agree with the fact that there will be a privacy issue involved when we go for advertising via WhatsApp. But there, it becomes a must, because when we check the company, that competitor of Facebook, that is Tencent, when they have a good market, especially in that WeChat app, and when Facebook has no revenue growth from WhatsApp, it has to find some revenue streams through WhatsApp. So we recommended them to go for advertising strategy in WhatsApp. However, those advertising strategies should ensure privacy concern as well. We have to ensure that.
Thank you. And on Tencent, so Tencent, the strategy seems to me to be all about moving into the global market, so starting with Southeast Asia and moving westwards from there. That exposes Tencent to competition with companies that it's not currently exposed to competition with. So because the Chinese market doesn't include at the moment Facebook, but also Google and other global giants, and Tencent's offering is more diverse than Facebook's, that means that they'll be competing not just with Facebook, but with Google and with others as well. How will they deal with that challenge?
So like Tencent has a core competence of innovation. They're quite innovative with their products and the services that they provide. And like they have the technical expertise as well. So we believe that it is strong enough to compete with the tech giants. But however, like as a first step, they have to first move into the Southeast Asian market. And with the success they gain from that, like think of moving west. So like that process would take quite a number of years. So through that also they'll be experienced and they'll be exposed to the different circumstances. So we believe that the company can grow in the coming years, and we will have the strength to compete against the other companies.
Adding on to that, as far as Facebook is concerned, they are into only social media, which is a bit narrower than Tencent service.
Yes.
So when Tencent is to serve a wide range of products, they will be definitely exposed to a large set of customers and large set of competitors, because if we select one product, they'll be having a set of competitors. So since they produce wide range of products, definitely they will have competitors. But it becomes a must for Tencent to have a global presence, because just operating in China and over relying on Chinese market would not going to be beneficial in long term, because customer preferences do change rapidly. So only over relying on Chinese market and depending on that market and getting revenues from that market is not going to work out. Also, the data states that they are into foreign, such as India and Thailand, but they are not focusing on that. Because of their lack of focus, they have failed to perform well in India and Thailand, where the government has specifically stated not to use their payment system. So they have to concern that issue as well.
Thank you. One last question, and I'll hand over to the other judges. What is the risk that it's about time now for a completely new upstart disruptor to totally overturn the market and upset all the calculations of both Facebook and Tencent?
Sorry,
what is the risk that a new company with a totally different business model will enter the market and completely disrupt everything that Facebook or Tencent might be planning?
That will happen, because things are uncertain. That will happen. The chances are there. But it gets like some time for customers, maybe the consumers all over the world who are using Facebook to get to know that information. Before customers going into that part, maybe Facebook should come with some new strategies and behave as a first mover. Because during that period, definitely like when we think Asian and European market, customers will take at least some point of time to react to that. So during that some point of time, as she said, this is a marathon. Facebook and Tencent have to do that marathon and win that race.
Thanks for asking.
Yeah, I just wanted to say is that I'm going to Sri Lanka in end of July, and I booked all my trips to WeChat, to Tencent through WeChat. So I booked through this travel agency which have a local presence in Sri Lanka, but like all the service people are actually doing the work on WeChat. So I think it's already penetrating into the Southeast Asia countries. But my next question actually is irrelevant. With the technology trend of this very popular AI, have you thought about how either of the both companies adapt AI into their growth strategy, or you think something's too far away?
comes to Tencent and Facebook, they both are into artificial intelligence. They are currently having artificial intelligence, and that's why we have decided, like, when it comes to their operations, current operations, Facebook as well as Tencent, they have to invest, but our plan is mainly focusing on a short period of time, because they have, like, before moving into artificial intelligence, they have to solve the current issues that they have. When it comes to Facebook, they have to solve the issues that they are currently facing in their product mix. And when it comes to Tencent, they before moving into artificial intelligence, they have to focus on what they are the issues that they are currently having.
So, and adding on to that, like you said, in Sri Lanka, like, people are becoming smartphone addicted. They are becoming online users as well. Like, in the past, they always prefer physical stores. They always placed orders on offline. But right now, there's a trend in Sri Lanka, like, where people are becoming online users. They make their orders, they book everything via online. So they, by investing on artificial intelligence, they will have a prospect in Asian market as well. We believe that they will be having good prospect in Asian market too.
We were talking about the e-commerce. Have you done it before yourself?
E-commerce, like, find things online?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And your favorite, what is the most important thing for the e-commerce? Security, paying system, and what?
The main element becomes the security, which is directly connected with the paying system.
Yeah.
Because as far as the security is concerned, we will, as customers, they will have to make their payments, so the credit card numbers, there are chances that get misused. So security becomes the main element when it comes to customers making their online purchases.
Because I have done some e-commerce in Facebook, and I think the logistics is most important. And they are user-friendly. No need to pay credit card. The logistic will collect the cash. So have you done before?
Cash on delivery.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think that the logistic is the main important, and of course the payment is very important too.
Most of the time when we make our payment, like whatever it is, we don't make the cash on delivery. We have to give our credit card number, the payment card, and buy our credit.
International payments, we have to make it through the card. So if it is a local company we are purchasing, we can pay
for cash on
the card. Is it even can use the cash in Sri Lanka? In your country?
Yes.
Okay.
I think developer in terms of qualitative analysis or whole expansion, strategy expansion, so go global or manage the mix. But have you done any quantitative number crunching of what would be the estimated cost of investing, spending, say, into India, into Thailand, what would be the potential upside in terms of the revenue generation, and how many years can Tencent, say, get back the money? And also in terms of Facebook, have you done any numbers in terms of what would be expected revenue, additional revenue from
Facebook? Like, we have expected the monthly users, it could reach around 1.9 million monthly users because of a new alteration we are going to do. So when it comes to Tencent, there will be a revenue growth because they are diversified, but still they are more focused on China. So while, as our strategy suggested, we are going to move to other countries, so we have suggested 250 RMB. RMB in 2018, because it would take around 2 years for all the expansion activities to be done.
What would be the initial cost for investing into those countries? Or first, what would be the countries you recommend them going to? Yeah, I remember is that Southeast Asia, which is a particular one.
Maybe they can focus on Singapore, Japan, those areas, they can cover them. They can have a very strong presence in Southeast Asia. Maybe like Macau, Japan, Singapore, even in Sri Lanka as well. And also we predicted that in the next 2 years, the revenue streams for, especially for Tencent, would be much higher even though the initial cost is much higher, we predict the future prospect is there for Tencent because they are doing really well in Chinese market. So they have a very good potential to have very good potential, and they have a good amount of core competencies. So they can make use of that by entering into other parts of Asian market as well. So we predict the revenues shall grow by maybe 20% or maybe 20 to 60%.